Figma recently released a new feature, which is called MCP server, which means now you can finally transfer your designs into code in just like several clicks. And this is so huge, you can't even believe it. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to set up an MCP server and how to transfer your designs from Figma to code. Hi, my name is Sergey. I'm a creative director and visual designer, and also I love to teach Figma and Framer. So if you're new to this channel, welcome, and please subscribe if you haven't already and like the video if you like it. And thank you so much for your support on my last video. I got lots of positive feedback. Thank you so much, and I'm glad that you liked it. So what the heck is the MCP server? Basically, it's a tool or a script that allows you to transfer some data from one source to an LLM app, which basically means that you can transfer your, in our case, transfer your designs, so get the data from Figma and send it to a app, which is AI app, like, so it can be a cursor or ChatGPT, anything like that. So basically, these are all LLM software. We're gonna use Cursor, and I recommend it to you because it's the easiest one on the market, I think. First of all, you need to do some preparation work, and we'll start with Figma. I'll show you an example of this calculator, which I built using auto layouts. This is very important to use auto layouts for creating your designs in Figma currently. And also it's very important to use variables. These things that you need to learn, if you're not sure how to use them, you can check out my other videos on the channel. I already have set up variables here. Let's check them out. So basically what I did, I have two groups. I have groups for colors and I have groups or group for spacing. Basically, it's spacing I'm gonna use in my designs. So basically, anywhere where I have a number, I will use a variable. So let's check it out. For example, this button, this is a component. This is very important also to use components. Here, I selected a button and check this out. I have the gap. You see, I set up the variable 8. And also I have these paddings. It's 24 left and right padding, and also top and bottom padding over here is 24 as well. Also I have set up the colors. So basically this is my button color, and the text color is also here. This is the text color. For the second button, also the same thing. Every number here, also the corner radius, you see I have set up two variables as well. Same thing for the calculator itself. All the colors are in variables, and all the numbers here are also in variables. You see all the spacings, everything, I use variables. So next, what I need to do, I need to go to Figma settings, actually it's called preferences, and here I need to check this thing over here, enable dev mode MCP server. Currently I'm using Figma beta, so you can get it from official Figma website. Just Google it, Figma beta. As far as I know, currently you can use it in the free plan, but I'm not sure about this because I have a paid plan, but check that out as well. But I think it's free and beta right now. So this is it. This is all you need to do in Figma. Now we need to open our browser, and there is a special like a blog post on Figma website, the article that tells you how to set up a MCP server. And here we need to click on cursor here because we're gonna use cursor, and we'll need this code over here. You see, this is the configuration. We need to copy it. Now we go to cursor website, cursor.com. We download the app. We register there if you're not there yet. Then we just open the app. Here I opened the app, and now I need to go to settings over here, and I need to look for tools and integrations. And here If you just open the cursor and this is your first time setting up MCP server, you're not gonna have this. But let's set up a new one. So I just like press plus. And here you need to paste your code from the Figma's website. We just copied, right? So we copy it and I paste it over here. So you see, save it, just close it and wait a couple of seconds and it will load up. You see it loading tools. You can like test it like this. Yep, you see it's ready now. So everything is ready. You see variables here, some get image, blah, blah, blah. This is all good. So basically now you're all set up. Now you need to just create a new file. I have a folder open where all my files are for the cursor. So it's cursor files. And now what we need to do, guys. So this is the beginning of the new era. We open our Figma file again. I select the frame where my design is, our design of the calculator. I just select it like this. I go to cursor again, and now I text the prompt. So basically I wrote the prompt. It's really simple. So let's check it out how it's gonna work. I have no idea, but let's check it out. Important thing that I'm not pasting anything in the in this prompt field. I only opened my Figma file. So basically I just selected the file here and that's it. Just in case, check that your file is in can view mode, because I noticed sometimes cursor doesn't see the file. Just in case, check it, but it should work without it, but just check. So here I have anyone can view, right? So I select the frame with my design. I'm not copying anything, just go here. So I just wrote the prompt. I use agent Claude 3.5 Sonnet on the free plan. And now I press send and let's see what's gonna happen. You see generating, understood what I wanna do. And now it asks me that it's calling a function, a get code. So I need to press run tool. So I agree with that. You see we have a check mark, so everything works. And now it wants to get the image, like the visual references. Basically, I guess this is the part where it collects all the data of my styles and all that stuff. And now it begins to generate the code. So basically it generates the index HTML. You see it's right here. And now it generates CSS file. That's basically the styles. So this is the code. This is the layout in the HTML. And now it generates the styles. And if I open my folder with the project, I can see here already two files, the index HTML and style CSS. I also can see them over here. So these are the styles got from my variables. And now it generates the most interesting thing. It's crazy. It generates a script, a JavaScript to make it interactive. So this is so cool, guys. This is amazing. And now it wrote some information, what it's done, and I press accept all. And now let's see what happened. So I just opened my file and as you can see, we got the layout, we got our design from Figma to code. We can inspect it so we can see that this is real code. You see everything is there, proper naming, all the divs, everything looks pretty cool. Yes, I understand that it's not exactly in the same style that we had in Figma. You see here, it was kind of more interesting. But let's see if it works. So let's check it out. I press AC, so I like cancel it, the numbers, you see. And now I can click on, for example, 10 plus 5 equals to 15. Can you imagine that? It actually works. So it's not just a prototype. It's a working code, a working calculator. 10, for example, multiply by 3 equals to 30. It works. This is so amazing. Can you imagine that? I can't. We just got the real code off the calculator in like several minutes. So let's try to fix it. Yep. So let's send this prompt and let's see what's going to happen now. And now it gives me an error. When I was testing, I saw this error a couple of times. It means probably that a lot of people are trying to use a cursor right now and it's overloaded. But I waited like a few minutes and tried it again. So don't worry, it's gonna work. All right, so I finally got the results after a few hours. And here what I got. So basically, I told him that there's a problem in the buttons design. And it fixed it, and then I said that there was an issue with the inner part of the button. It was really small, so I told him that you should make it 80 by 80 pixels. And it did some changes in the code, and this is what I got. So this is it, and now it looks really cool. Do you agree with me? So it works perfectly. The buttons look almost exactly as in the design. So here is the design, and this is the code. And it looks almost identical. Well, I have a problem with the zero, but I'll need like few more minutes to fix it. In any case, I believe this is the really cool example, and the most important thing that it actually works, so it has the logic. And you can actually use this calculator to count your incomes from your clients. So basically, this is what I was waiting for so long. And I guess a couple of years ago, I thought of it that someday it's gonna come when designers will be more like engineers. And we're not gonna wait for a front-end developer to develop our website or our designs. Now, designers will be able to do that by themselves. And I'm not talking about transferring your designs from Figma to, for example, a no-code tool like Framer or Webflow. We're talking real code like HTML, CSS, JavaScript. And this is so cool because, for example, personally, I don't code. I like know some of it, basics of coding, but I can't and I don't want to code the whole app or whole website, right? And now I can do it because of this feature, and I can transfer my designs from Figma to Cursor and create an app or website. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you like it. So please don't forget to hit the like button below and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done already. And in the comments, please tell me, what do you think of the MCP server? And what do you think of these things happening? And I wish you luck in setting up your MCP servers and turning your designs into code. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.